Rohatgi. Welcome to News Hour Direct. The big question, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, is that with such an outpouring on the streets, is the centre in a position to give a solution to the state of Tamil Nadu?
See, let me tell you the legal position first. The central law relates to cruelty to animals. While if this is a case of a traditional sport of a local area or a local state, as it is, because Jallikattu is not celebrated in the rest of the country or in major parts of the country. Now, sports is governed by what is called in the constitution the state list. The state list means that the subjects which are mentioned in the state list, and it includes sports, it is only the exclusive privilege of the state legislature to make a law relating to sports within the state. That is not a power with the center at all, because the constitution demarcates the role of the center, the role of the states, and there is one list which is called concurrent list, where both can make legislation, and if both make legislation, then the central law prevails. But as far as sports is concerned, it is in the exclusive jurisdiction of the state. Now, if it is a case of sports or culture or the Dravidian culture, whatever I've been seeing on TV, then certainly the state has power to make a law. Now, the state could consider making a law treating it as a traditional sport, but the state must keep in mind while framing a law, such a law, that there is no cruelty attached to the sport. It should not just be for sport without bothering to see the plight of the animal. I mean, you have bullfights in Spain, don't you? Now, those are cases where bulls are killed. But here, when I argued this case earlier, people in Tamil Nadu and other places revere the bull. It is not that they treat the bull with cruelty. So the law can allow a sport subject to stringent conditions, that there will not be anybody in a distance of 100 feet, nobody can throw stones, nobody can do any acts of cruelty, and if the same are found to be done, then there can be punishment, etc., etc. So that the concerns of the Supreme Court rendered in the judgment, the concerns of the Cruelty Act are also kept in view, and a balanced position can be found by the state concerned. That, I think, is the correct legal position.
You're saying the position, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, as stated by the Prime Minister today to the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, O Paneer Selvam, when he met him. We understand the government has said that the 7th schedule, 2nd list and 33rd entry is the sports, and therefore the state government should take a decision on this entire issue. But Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, the judgment of May 7, 2014 had a list by the then government, by the then Environment Minister Jairam Ramesh, proposing that bull be one of those animals against whom cruelty should not be practiced. Can the animal bull's name be removed from that list? That's the question people in Tamil Nadu are asking today.
Listen, I have told you what the legal position is. I didn't know what the Prime Minister told the Tamil Nadu Chief Minister. I have not seen that. So what I have told you is what the state can do. As far as central government, and coming back to that question, why can't a state law be made keeping proper concerns relating to cruelty within the act? If that is done, then both concerns are met. That's one. Secondly, you asked me a question about the prevention of cruelty to animals act. That is a central law. Certainly, the law can be amended by Parliament. There is no doubt about it. It can be amended. But if it is a sport in a local area, then should not that have more focus? Is the question I ask. Why should it be put on the center? The center is dealing with a law relating to cruelty. I am saying let the state make a law relating to sport minus any forms of cruelty and stringent punishment for those if any cruelty is exercised.
But
I mean, merely because somebody may have some cruelty doesn't mean that the sport itself must be abolished.
But Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, you've been defending the center's notification of January 7, 2016 before the Supreme Court. Now, was that not a political move given the fact that the Ministry of Environment and Forest came out with a notification allowing Jallikattu in Tamil Nadu, this with elections at that time when they were a few months away? So a political move was made, the move that you are defending in court before the Supreme Court. Why is the center shying away, and are you advising the center not to take such a political decision at this hour?
No, listen, Navika, let me tell you. Firstly, I don't know about political moves or not. A notification is issued by the central government or a ministry. I go and defend it. I am not concerned why it was issued. It is my job to defend it and make my submissions in court. The notification attempted to meet the concerns of activists who talk about cruelty. That is what the notification said. The matter has been argued, judgment has been reserved. That's number one. Number two, I have not advised the central government as of today to do a particular thing or not a particular thing. And nobody in the central government has asked me to give any advice on what the central government can do. And I'm telling you on TV for the first time what I feel the legal position is and what can be done. In fact, I have not advised anybody on this issue in the last few days.
So, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, if you were asked by the government on whether it's possible for the government to bring in an ordinance, what would your advice be? Can the centre bring in an ordinance on this entire issue? Is it within the domain of the centre to bring in an ordinance and allow Jallikattu? Or Mr. are you saying that option is not available to the centre, that's only with the state government?
No, please understand. I told you a complete law relating to sports with concerns of cruelty can certainly be brought by the state. That is their constitutional right. Nobody can stop it. That's number one. Number two, if there is a central law, forget this law, any central law, the right to amend that law, whether by ordinance or by an amending act of parliament, is the prerogative of parliament through the central government. It's as simple as that.
So you're saying that, you know, if the center does decide on this issue when the Supreme Court judgment is pending, will it set a precedent? Don't talk just as the Attorney General, also talk as somebody who's seeing the developments happening on the ground in Chennai, in other parts of Tamil Nadu. This is a spontaneous movement. This is a spontaneous outpouring on the streets of Tamil Nadu. Do you think there is a danger that every Supreme Court judgment can be then hijacked by such emotional outpourings of people on the streets of various states?
See, Navika, sometimes these issues raise emotional aspirations, but we have to think coolly. The law of the land must prevail. So you can't have a situation where a judgment of a court is hijacked by personal emotions of a group or a city, etc., etc. And as I told you, those emotions are in a part of the state, and the state is best empowered to deal with it.
So, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, to make this more understandable for our viewers who are watching us tonight, you're saying that if the Supreme Court judgment on the notification is still pending, the state can go ahead and undertake a legislation in the Tamil Nadu Assembly because this is a state subject in the 33 item of the 7th schedule?
That's right. They can do it. There is no legal or constitutional bar for the state not to act as soon as it wants to.
So you're saying the onus is on Tamil Nadu government to call for a special assembly session to pass a law on Jallikattu if they so want to do and resolve this problem that they are facing as far as outpourings of people are concerned.
Right, absolutely right. And whether they call a special session or they issue an ordinance, that's up to them. Because as you know, the right to bring a law or issue an ordinance is the same right in Parliament for the whole of India and the same right in a state assembly for the state.
All right, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, we will continue to follow you. We will continue to ask you the questions. If the center also were to take any advice from you on the issue of Jallikattu, sure. Even about bringing an ordinance at the center, sure. Which you are saying is something that the government has not yet sought your advice on. Thank you very much for joining us, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, on this News Hour Direct on the very special and emotional subject of Jallikattu in Tamil Nadu.